going to take you with me as I mark some trees to be cut on my own land, which I call Bear Island. One thing to know about this forest is that when I bought it in 2017, it was one of the most degraded forests I'd ever seen. Among many other issues, one thing that had happened to it is that 30 years ago, it was high graded. So basically all the biggest, healthiest trees were cut and all the least healthy trees were left behind. So now I've begun this like 100-year-long restoration process to make this forest healthy again. Now, sometimes there are healthy trees here that are being competed with by less healthy trees. So all that we need to do is just to cut that less healthy tree to help make sure that that healthier tree makes it. In some other cases, there are just no healthy trees to be found anywhere. And so we're cutting areas of trees to promote regeneration. So I know it can be really confusing to think about how the cutting of a tree could be something positive and even generative. But as you watch this, I want you to open your mind to the idea that every time I'm marking a tree to be cut, I'm actually planting a seed so that this forest can be healthier for the future. And every time I'm cutting a tree, I'm either giving a healthier tree more room to grow, or I'm creating an opportunity for new trees to grow and for the forest as a whole to be healthier.
Okay, so here we have an unhealthy red maple tree and an unhealthy little beech that's competing with the crown of this big oak tree. Oak is a species that really got cut 30 years ago, and that's what we want to encourage. So we're going to mark both of these. So this ash tree is actually a tree that's healthy, but emerald ash borer is coming into this area and we're expecting almost all the ash trees are going to die. That doesn't mean that you should go and cut all of your ash trees, but in the case of this one, I can cut this tree, capture a little bit of value in the tree, and there's actually a beautiful red oak over there, which is a species that has a better chance of being healthy in the future that we're going to encourage by cutting this tree. Here we have another few ash trees competing with healthy oak. Basswood, which is a species we don't have a lot of here, so we really want to encourage. And also these two other smaller ash trees that are competing with this cluster of sugar maple, which is another species we don't have a lot of. Almost all the hemlock on the site was cut 30 years ago. So we're going to cut this white birch and this red maple to release these two hemlocks. So here we have these two not super healthy red maples that are competing with this really nice red oak. So we're going to cut these two trees to release that tree, and then also by cutting two trees right close together, create a little opening for some regeneration. Oaks are really good at sprouting from their stumps. That's why they're such a fire-adapted species. So in the case of this oak, I'm going to actually cut it in hopes that it will resprout and form a more straight trunk. Here we have another two red maples, both competing with a much healthier oak, so we're going to cut the red maples. Oak is a species that's really missing here as a result of past management, but you also do sometimes have to cut oak trees to promote healthier oak trees. So here we have two oak trees. There's not enough room for both of them to grow. And this oak tree on the right has a much healthier canopy. It's overtopping this other one. So if we want to give this one more room to grow, to expand its crown, to produce more acorns, we actually have to cut this oak tree. The same is true for these two oak trees. This one's healthier, this one's less healthy. So we gotta cut this one to give this one more room to grow. I'm also gonna put an arrow pointing up in this tree to remind me to be aware of this dead spruce right here so it doesn't fall on me. So here we have this yellow birch tree. It doesn't have any value in the traditional sense in terms of ever producing a valuable timber, but it does have a lot of character. It has some cavities, some internal rot, and so I'm just going to leave that as a legacy tree solely for its ecological value. Release that oak tree. Release this red oak tree by cutting this unhealthy red maple tree. Releasing this little red spruce tree by cutting this unhealthy red maple tree. Spruce is another species that we want to encourage here. I'm actually going to try to leave this white birch tree. I don't think it's going to be alive for much longer anyway, and it has some of these really good cavities.
So I just laid out about a quarter paint, and I'm going to come back with a skidder, cut these trees, have a little bit of firewood, but mostly just make this forest more healthy, more diverse, and help it recover from some of the wounds of the past. It's one of these things that is really hard to understand as someone who loves trees. Forest management and the death of trees can be such a celebration and can really put this forest on a better path for the future.